I'm going to do a little series and talk about predictive processing and active inference, the concept of a predictive brain and what that means, because I've been talking about it a lot and I want to make it more concrete for people. The first thing I'm going to say is that it's really important to understand that this is not just a new way to talk about the same old thing. When we say the brain is predictive and not reactive, that means, in a nutshell, that you create your experience. You know, experience doesn't come into your eyes and then you do your little computation and then you see what's real out there. It means that your brain, throughout your entire life, has been taking in information, patterns of sensory data, like patterns of light, patterns of sound, and there's this hierarchy of things at the very bottom, which are light waves and photons, and then there's a next higher up level, which is angles, and this goes all the way up to something like a face or something like a community. The bottom line is that what that means is that over time, these patterns have created in your brain something called a model. Your brain carries a model of your body in the world. So every moment of your life, you're generating inside of your brain your reality outside of you. And the difference is that anything that makes it into your brain is something that your brain didn't predict. And that's the only thing that makes it into your brain. It's not that something real out there has reached your brain. It's that your brain didn't generate the right model of the information outside of you. And that gets very complicated. I'm just going to say this, and I'm going to keep explaining it in various ways so that hopefully it makes some sense. Because once it makes sense, it's really mind-blowing. It means that the beliefs you have inside, that the beliefs that you have built up in your brain about how your body works in this world and how the world works and how your body works in this world, it means that those beliefs are your reality. And again, if that doesn't blow your mind, then I need to do a lot more explaining because it's not sinking in. It's sort of hitting up against that old idea of you're taking in reality and cogitating and coming up with your perception. And then your brain gets triggered into a reaction. And that's just not how it works at all. So that's the first part. We'll see where we go from here. See you next time.